whenever possible, it is better to mark a ball on the outside of the ball, viewing the inside of the hoop, in preference to marking markers across the middle of the ball, which is less precise. Secondly, a rule of thumb is to try to get the two lines to approximately be 90 degrees apart, and this is more accurate than using different markers using different legs. The worst thing, in my view, to do is to use a middle of the ball for one marker and the outside of a ball for another, because this is how easy mistakes in repositioning the ball exactly are made. A second method of accurately marking balls is to use the dead center of the ball from the marker through the center of the ball to the inner edge of the upright as shown. This, in fact, is the technique recommended currently by the Australian Croquet Association. Here is an equally good and alternate way, using the inner edge of either upright. So the left-hand marker views the left-hand side of the ball to the right upright, and vice versa for the right-hand marker. This is perfectly effective. Remember, the idea is to get the marker some distance away to prevent distracting or assisting the striker of the ball. Here, four markers are used. While this may be helpful, it takes much more time. It uses the center of the ball and probably doesn't assist with these black markers any more than you would obtain with the first using of the red markers. Note to avoid the areas marked with X's before and after the ball, which will distract the player and not assist with the marking accurately of the ball. Yet another technique, assisting a ball that is within the actual hoop. This is critical and may well require lateral markers, which seem to have disappeared off this diagram.